Hi, in this short video, I want to show you how to back up a course from the existing Enable, that's the one we've been using for the last couple of years, and move that course into the new Enable. So here's the old one here. You can see this is the Year 9 Commerce course. And over on this tab here, this is the new Enable. This is also the Year 9 Commerce course, but as you can see, there's nothing in here. The topics are all empty. It's a completely empty course. So the plan is to come back to the original one, back up everything that's in here into a file, and then restore that file into the new course. That's the plan. Let's look at how that's done. So let's go to the old course. I'm logged in, and I scroll down here to the administration block, and you'll see there is an option here to backup, and along with it, one to restore. Think of backup and restore as pepper and salt, or gin and tonic, two things that belong together, okay? Backup and restore. So I will choose backup, and it takes me to this page here and asks me what I want to backup, because the course is made up of, well, as you can see, a whole bunch of resources. There's Word documents and PDFs and stuff. There's also quizzes and forums and discussions and wikis and all sorts of things that could be part of the course. We obviously want to bring the content across, but not the user data. We don't want all the stuff the kids have actually done. We want the course to come in as a new, fresh course with no interaction in it yet. So let's just, at the top of this, we could go and turn these off one by one, but just at the top here, it says all or none. Just click the word none, and it just turns them all off for you in one hit. So all, none, just like that. Scroll down a little bit to the bottom. By the way, if there's any resources here you don't want to bring across, so for example, his Walla homework, getting a loan, let's say you don't want that because it's not relevant for next year, you can turn off individual bits and pieces. So just bear that in mind. In this section here, it asks you a few more questions about what you want to bring across. I don't want to bring any users across, so I'm going to turn the users to none. I don't want any log files, so say no. I don't want any user files, say no. I do want the course files. That's all the stuff that makes up the course, so yes, I do want those. And I do want any site files used in this course, and I don't want any grade histories. So that's all fine. As far as backing up the role assignments, I think it would be probably safe to turn off students and guests, but leave everything else. Click continue. And it gives you this warning that we're bringing in no user data. Well, that's good. That's what we wanted to do. So just ignore that little warning there in red. This is the file that it will back up to. That's the name there. The naming convention is pretty straightforward. It's the word backup followed by the name of the course, followed by the year, month, day, and time, .zip. That's how it names the file. This is just a confirmation page to just say this is what you're about to do. And if you're happy with it, you say continue. And it goes ahead and exports all of that stuff, and it says backup completed successfully. Be patient with that. If it's a big course, it can take a little while to complete this step, a couple of minutes sometimes. So just be patient if it's a bit slow. Hit continue, and there is your backed up file. It actually goes into a folder called backup data in the file section of the course, and that's the file there. Now this one is 19.3 megabytes, which is reasonably large. I will download it to my computer. And you can do that the way you would download any file to your computer. You right-click on it and say Save Link As. And it then offers to download it. I will put it on the desktop where I can find it and say Save. And you can see down here in the corner here, it's now just downloading that to my computer. I'm at home at the moment on a reasonably fast connection, so that's downloading. But it should be even quicker than this when you do it from school. And done. Okay, so that's now on my computer. So you can see here it is here. It's called Backup 09 Commerce, and there's the date. And so that's the file we're talking about. All right, so that's part A done. Let's go over to the new course, which is here. And now we have to restore it from that backup. In the settings block, which in the old Moodle used to be called administration, it's now called settings, find the link that says restore. Click the restore link. And we have to now just import that backup file. Now, I'm about to do this on my home computer. It will take me a little longer. It'll be much quicker from school. But essentially, you just choose a file, go and find it on the desktop. Now, I'll show you a little shortcut. I'll just move this window out of the way. You can actually take that backup file and just drag it into that box and let it go. And that will actually do the download for you. Okay, and you can see here is the file now. It's been imported into the course, and now that's the file we're going to use to restore. So click the restore button. And we get this warning that says the selected file is not a standard Moodle backup file. That's simply because we're bringing it from Moodle 1.9 into Moodle 2, and so it sees it as a slightly different file. Just ignore that warning and say continue. All right, now it wants to know where we're going to put this course, because we could restore it as a new course, as an existing course. We could merge it into a different course. We actually want to restore it into the course we're currently in, which is the non-commerce course. So we want to merge the backup course into this existing course. So that's the choice you want there. Say continue. Okay, this is just confirming the settings we're bringing in. Remember, we turned off all the user files and whatnot, so that's not coming in. That's fine, so just go to the next step. Again, this is just confirming that this is what we're in fact bringing into this new course. As you can see, there's no user data, but we're getting all of the files we brought across. If you changed your mind and brought across something you didn't mean to, you can turn it off at this stage just by unticking it, but I'll bring everything in. Scroll to the bottom here and say next. One more chance here just to review. This is just telling you this is everything that will be done. I'm good with all of that. Let's perform the restore. Okay, and it now says the course was restored successfully. Click the continue button and view the course. So we click continue. And now we see here's the course fully restored. Here's all the stuff that we brought across from the old one. It should be pretty reliable. I haven't experienced too many problems. There you go. So we brought everything across. It didn't seem to like that image, but we'll go and have a look and see what the problem was there. But other than that, it's brought it in pretty well. You will find that if you've used any of these header graphics in your courses, that they are actually bigger than what this particular layout we're using now fits, and they in fact scroll sideways like that. We can fix that later on. For now, just concern yourself with getting all your course content across. We can fix all those little niggly problems a little bit later. So hopefully that will sort you out with how you bring a course from the old Moodle into the new Moodle. Realistically, by the time you get into the swing of doing this, notwithstanding the fact that if you have a really big course and it may take a little while to download and re-upload, but realistically for most courses, it shouldn't be more than 5 or 6 minutes to bring a course across. So for most of you, for most subjects, I would imagine you can knock all this over in about an hour or so. If you need any help with it, of course, please ask. Hope that helps.